Hi there! Welcome back to Geekly.edu, where we help you learn more each day. Today, we will talk about one of the rules of probability, the addition rule. We will use this rule, for example, if we want to know the probability that you interact with us. You can interact by commenting, liking the video, or subscribing to the channel, but each of these options has different probability. The addition of the probability of two events, A and B, will give us a new set of probability. The probability of A union B that is equal to the probability of the event A plus the probability of the event B, minus the probability of the simultaneous occurrence of events A and B. To understand this formula, we can do the Venn diagram, being a circle the probability of the event A and a second circle the probability of B. The intersection of these circles is the simultaneous occurrence of A and B. We shall rest this intersection, otherwise we would be counting this area of the Venn diagram twice. Let's see an example. Using the addition rule, what is the probability of rolling a 4 or a 3 when a dice is rolled? There is only one face of the dice with the number 3. That is why the probability is 1/6, and the same happens with 4. Then the probability is 1/6. The simultaneous occurrence is equal to 0, because the dice can give us only one number at a time. Substituting in the formula, we get that the probability of 3 union 4 is equal to 1/3. This is a case of mutually exclusive events, and we can use a formula for these cases, where the probability of union A and B are the addition of probabilities of A and B. If we use the Venn diagram for the addition of mutually exclusive events, we can see that the simultaneous occurrence is equal to 0 and the probability A and probability B are represented again with a circle. In this second example, we are going to use the general rule. In a classroom with 30 students, 18 are women and 12 men. Two women are younger than 20 and 3 men are younger than 20 years. If you pick a person, what is the probability that the person you picked is a woman younger than 20 years old? We need to analyze the information given and consider what is the information we need. In a group of 30, 18 are women. So the probability of being a woman is 18 in 30, equal to 0.6. Now the probability of picking someone under 20 years is 5 in 30. In this case, we also need to count the men that are younger than 20. And finally, the simultaneous occurrence of being younger than 20 and being a woman. That is 2 in 30. Using the formula, we only need to substitute the information and compute the result. And the probability of picking a woman under 20 is 0.7. Now, what happens if we want to use this rule to know a new set of probabilities resulting of the addition of 3 or more probabilities? We have a probability of A, a probability of B, and as we did before, we have to subtract the simultaneous occurrence of A and B. Then we have a third probability, C, and also the simultaneous occurrence of A and C and B and C. If we subtract these two simultaneous occurrences, we have to add the simultaneous occurrence of A, B, and C. Finally, we got a new formula for this case, when we have three different events and this is a new set of probabilities. In the next video, you will learn how to use the multiplication rule of probability, but meanwhile, I'll let you with the formulas we studied today. You can take a screenshot of these formulas so you can use it later.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications to always get the newest videos straight to your feed.